Hey guys, my next recommended book is Outlive by Peter Attia. Dr. Attia operates a medical practice in Austin, Texas, and some of you may be familiar with his podcast, The Drive. He's someone who takes a very measured and analytical approach to medicine, and he's branded this thinking Medicine 3.0. Rather than simply treating a patient when they're sick, he invests a lot of time and effort onto the preventative side of healthcare. In the book, he uses the term slow deaths to describe the diseases of aging, like cancer and dementia. They're slow because they involve cumulative processes that take place across several decades of life, even if symptoms themselves only show up in the final few years. For that reason, we can take action much sooner than we think, intervening as early as our 20s to ensure a healthy retirement. The interventions are shared in the final part of the book, where he labels them the four pillars. Those pillars are exercise, nutrition, sleep, and emotional health. It's packed full of actionable insights to extend not only our lifespan, but our health span too, which is the number of years we live in good health. As you'll hopefully agree, there's no use living to 120 if you're in a hospital bed from the age of 80. So as with previous book reviews, I'm going to pull out three of my favorite concepts, the first of which is the centenarian decathlon. The idea here is that you need to factor in the natural decline in your health and fitness with age when considering what you want to be able to do when you're older. The classic example is picking up a child. On average, strength declines by 5 to 8% every decade from the age of 35. So if you want to be able to pick up 10 kilos, the average weight of a one-year-old child, when you're 60, then it's not enough that you can do it when you're 45. You actually need to be stronger than that. The same goes for cardiovascular fitness, which can decline twice as fast as strength. If you want to be independent when you're much older, walking to the shops on your own, then you have to set a much higher fitness bar for yourself right now in anticipation of the age-related decline. Dr. Attia encourages his patients to write a list of a dozen or so activities that they'd like to be able to do when they're much older. They would then work backwards from this list to set fitness goals at their current age that would allow them to reach those long-term goals. It's called a decathlon not because you need to pick exactly 10 goals, but because the mentality needed in old age is to consider all aspects of your health. You have to address your weaknesses and not just pat yourself on the back for your strengths. A decathlete is someone who trains in all the disciplines. They may not be the best at any one thing, but they're above average in everything. It's the same with health. It's no use being exceptionally strong if you're neglecting mobility and you end up with back, knee, and hip problems in later life. The second concept is that being in the normal range is not the same as being in the optimal range. That extends to things like measures of strength and fitness, as well as in blood test results. One of the examples he gives is for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, which affects more than 1 in 4 people. The first sign of damage to the liver would be in a blood test for ALT. While there is a defined normal range, within that there is a narrower optimal range. Being outside of the optimal range should already be motivation for people to take action, in this case doing things like reducing their alcohol intake, rather than waiting for it to get into the high range and they start to develop symptoms. Another one highlighted in the book is protein. The recommended dietary allowance for protein is 0.8 grams per kilo of body weight, so around 60 grams for someone my weight. Dr. Attia's recommendations are at least double that, so 1.6 grams per kilo body weight, if not higher. The difference is that one of them is enough to stop you becoming deficient, and the other one is closer to what you'd need for optimal health. And to finish, the core concept of the book, which is his Medicine 3.0 approach. Medicine 2.0 is what most of us experience right now. You go about your life until you develop a symptom, you go to the doctor and you get it treated. Put another way, your only experience with the healthcare system is when you're already sick. Not only is Medicine 3.0 about preventative healthcare, he also acknowledges that everyone is in some way unique and their treatment should reflect that, and that the focus should be on increasing health span, the number of years that people spend in good health. The book has many examples of tests and measurements you can do, including blood biomarkers you can check, assessments you can do at home or in the gym, as well as what an optimal range would look like for someone based on their age and sex. Personally, I think it's very important that people take a proactive approach to their health, tracking and monitoring on an annual or biannual basis so that they catch any trends early and address them before they go on to develop into full-on health conditions. Thank you for watching.